Backstage of Slayermike. We're invading the space of Piranha. Yeah. Thank you. I love this room. great.
Nice. It's high.
How long have you guys been in this space?
Probably about a year and a half.
We started out in St. Paul, in the studio down in St. Paul, and then after, you know, some debate, you know, about locations, we moved down here about a year and a half.
And Adam's huge ass drums out of
Yeah.
Need a little more room for that.
Yeah. So we've been here for about a year.
A year and a half. Are you guys up? Hello, pretty good?
Yeah. We're tired.
It 3 days ago, this place was trashed. I mean, it was
pretty metals.
I just hate playing in a dumpster.
Sounds like there was a tour guide now.
Dumpster belt. Big
shots off.
Garbage.
So how where did you guys get your name? How's the story behind Piranha?
You know what he's right here.
What would you say in all elaborate?
All right, I guess it was prana, which is like a breathing exercise.
Life force.
Changed it from there into piranha, because piranhas are about attack, and I think our music is about attack, so.
We were half-life in the beginning, you know, there were too many of those, so.
There's like two other bands in the state that had that.
Switching up a little bit.
Yeah.
That'll get you. Let's introduce ourselves. I think I forgot to. Evan is about the host. And we're with Piranha, so let's introduce
ourselves.
I know. Let's start over here.
My name's Adam Easterbrook. I'm the drummer for Piranha. Tracie and I are the brain children of this. We started back in 2005. Yeah, so her and I have been playing for a long time.
Between the two children.
That's mine.
So
who the hell are you?
Oh, I'm Tracie Rodmacher, and I've been playing with this project for 8 years. 05. And then a little bit with the band before that, and that's a life. So.
Sorry about that.
The studio has life.
Wait, where'd that
life
come from?
The walls are speaking.
Turn off the fan, the place explodes.
That's what it looked like there.
My name's Ryan Boyd. I've been with these guys for about 2.5 years, maybe. And it's kind of funny how we met. A friend talked me into going on MySpace, and I'm kind of the last person.
What's that?
MySpace. I was actually the last person to sign up for MySpace. You know,
just before it switched over.
And it's kind of funny because I was just, you know, surfing local bands and stuff like that, and you know, just kind of new to MySpace. And usually I don't tread on people's walls, but I saw these guys and I heard their stuff, and I liked it because it was metal, and I'm a big fan of metal, and it was really, you know, modern. It wasn't real old school, like a bunch of stuff that, you know, you can kind of, you know, take out an 80s record and, you know, hear, you know, similar riffs. So I like these guys. I really like their sound, so I just put like nice stuff. And then it was Tracie who messaged back and like, thanks, you know. And it just turned out they were looking for a guitar player. And I said, hey, you know, if anything, I like jamming with people. I'd love to jam with you guys, you know. And you know, and you guys
like
have a free
YouTube
night. Hey, buddy, thanks. And so anyway, I came down, and you know, we just kind of, you know, improv some stuff, and you know, it was going really good. And they gave me their last CD. Who are the band members in that last CD?
Tick and CD.
And Tracie and these guys, they gave me a copy of it, and I took it home, and I really liked it. And I was like, all right, I'd like to, you know, it sounds like you guys are looking for a guitar player. I'd like to learn the stuff. I'll come in and play it, and, you know, we can go from there. And, I mean, it was just, I was a real fan of the CD. We're actually working on one now. Plug. Is that okay?
Oh, yeah.
they multiply.
And another month, and I was just a big fan of the CD, so I came back and played it, and they, you know, I obviously like them. You know, we have our differences sometimes, right?
Fans don't do that.
But, yeah, I mean, I, you know, they
nobody
were...
Fights.
Yeah, nobody fights. And Now, they were nice enough to, you know, have me, you know, in the band, so I feel pretty fortunate, you know, ever since, so.
Hey, you guys mesh all together well.
We were afraid to swear in front of Floyd. We thought that from his profile
yeah, we say that.
He was, say whatever you want.
He was
you
in a
drink,
Christian band.
Fuck!
And we were trying to get him on the line, see, and I'm like, Ace, don't swear, you know.
She blew the cover before I did.
If I would have known that, I totally would have played it too.
Oh, that's funny.
Make him feel uncomfortable.
That's funny.
So from a Christian band to this. Wow. That's crazy. That's even quite
Yeah,
you know.
Looks like Piranha may have corrupted you a little bit.
we keep fairly tame lyrics, you know. Maybe I got to read up on them.
You got jokes.
He's an excellent lyricist. He's a poet. He doesn't ever bash God, but he gets all the anger out of his system.
So we're
the youth and all the sin, you know. I'm just saying, man, he's a genius. I mean, when you hear his lyrics, it's just like, man, I feel like I just got a lot of anger released, you know.
And
I didn't really hurt anybody in the process. So.
Yeah, I agree.
So who's this guy?
This guy. What's your name, sir?
Me. I didn't think we'd ever get to me. my name is Benjamin Nichols, and I am the lead singer of Piranha. Been so since, I think, was it like November 2009? Does that sound right?
Is that long?
That long, or is it 2010?
10.
10. 10. That's right. The years blend together, I swear. Yeah. But yes, I was found by this guy, Floyd. Floyd was 6 months before me, you came?
Something like that.
It's before I go any further, the reason I call him Floyd, his name is Ryan Boyd, we rhyme at Lion Floyd. So that's why he's Floyd. Moving on.
I think I've said so far was a complete lie.
Yeah, he's Lion Floyd. I've been in the band After Five for like 6 years, and drummer moved out of town, you know, put an ad on Craigslist, auditioned for all kinds of shitty bands that sucked. Anyway, then Floyd gets a hold of me on bandmix.com, right? And who the hell ever goes on Bandmix besides me and Floyd? Anyway,
we were the only two, so.
Yeah, so he runs away, and he told me everything I wanted to hear. Like, yeah, we're looking for a singer. We're like, you know, something along the lines of like Marilyn Manson and Slipknot, stuff like that. And we're like, whoa, really? It wasn't exactly what I heard, but it wasn't.
I don't think I mentioned Marilyn.
He sold it pretty good.
I was pretty sure I saw.
So
I still got the
email.
I still got it. All right, we'll investigate if he sent Manson or not.
Well, you know what the show is.
Anyway, also, it had been at least a month since he sent that message to the time I actually read it. And, because no one goes on fucking Bandmix. Anyway, so by the time I went to their page and they had a singer listed, and it shows pictures of him and shit like that. So I'm like, oh, they must have found their guy. So I moved on, auditioned for more shitty bands, and then like put out another ad, and Floyd gets over. God, it was a long time after the first one, but he's like. It's like, hey, you didn't answer me last time, whatever, I'm going to try this again. So
I think I actually wrote in there, I'm not taking no for an answer.
Yeah, at some point he told me that he wasn't taking no for an answer. So I came in the room, did some shit, and the rest, as they say, is history.
Right. He let out one scream and we looked at each other.
Yeah,
that was cool.
Did you do that?
Yeah, I'm kind of.
So where do you get that deep singing energy?
Oh my God, probably very angsty childhood. And I'm not saying that my life sucked or anything. I was just a kid, so I thought my life sucked. So you get angsty and you're like, yeah, fuck this and fuck that. Then all of a sudden, I heard it.
Perfect career.
Thank you. But yeah, just I hear my favorite singers and shit like that. I'm like, oh, that sounds so cool. I try to do it and I can't. And I try some more, then all of a sudden I could.
That's why you do your own stuff.
Right? Well, I said I could. Yeah.
So the creative minds are you too?
All of us. We all make music.
We co-write about every song.
Yeah. They came up with Piranha, like it was a band long before we formed. Yeah.
And the songs, where you guys get the ideas for your songs?
Just depends.
What the mood is.
We jam, someone brings something in, just go from there.
Yeah.
Try to just mesh stuff together.
Either way, you'll come up with something and,
Sometimes Adam will come up with a cool drum beat, and we'll kind of, play that again, and sometimes play what again? Come on, just play it again. You're like, I don't know what I did. It's like, come on, you just did it, And the same goes with me. I've been guilty of that too, and Tracie, we're just kind of wing it and, gather some ideas and, construct a song out of it. So,
great.
And then Bender usually puts some lyrics to it after that. So,
everyone, Piranha, we just heard them this past weekend, and they're fantastic. You guys got to come out and see them.
Please do.
Yeah, they're great. How would you classify your genre?
I kind of thought it was hard rock, heavy metal at first, but I guess it's kind of more metal now.
I know, I always hate to pigeonhole.
Yeah, the singing kind of makes it more metal-ish.
I would contest that point. The fact that when I heard you guys originally, I thought metal. I didn't think that I made the band into a metal band or anything like that. Floyd probably had something to do with it too.
It's gotten a little
heavier. We'll definitely say that.
We tried to write every song. Not every song, but it's like we tried to write every song a little bit more heavier than the last one, I think. But what'd you guys say? I do.
More evolved as the years go on, I'm sure.
Yeah.
So
music matures over time.
Exactly. So how would you describe from the beginning to where you guys are now and where you want to be in the future as far as musical?
Well,
I know that's a hard question.
In the beginning it was just more like Tracie and I basically met at a bar and we're trying to
Station 4.
Yep. So anyways, we just kind of talked and we just threw our instruments and ourselves in a room and tried to make it work. Just kind of started playing some more groove rock first, and then it kind of evolved. And as time goes on, it just keeps getting heavier.
Hey, you guys are fantastic.
Thanks.
You guys all collaborate really well.
Thank you.
Thanks.
So,
are you guys
going to
be doing an album soon, or do you have one in the making?
We're working on one now. It's called
Too Bad They Multiply, so don't have sex.
But I'll change you.
That's a wrap.
Well, if you suck, don't have sex. How about that?
We've been working on it since March.
No procreation.
We have enough people.
Yeah.
Most of them suck.
We've been working on it since March. We recorded at Sound Gallery Studio and Nick Vibeck down there. So that was good. It took a while. Finally got it done. Just got to get it mastered and distributed. And, hopefully it goes from there. So, it was quite the process. And, had a lot of fun doing it.
So you guys heard it here. The album's coming out.
Stay tuned.
Too bad they
multiply.
I love that.
Multiplication. Multiply, there we go.
So where can your fans find you?
You can find us on Facebook.
I'll put a link at the end of the video.
Piranha Metal.com. Unless someone nabs it before they get the title.
Don't say that out loud.
So hopefully.
No, it's www.facebook.com/piranhaband.
Yes.
Yeah, Reverb then too, or?
Yeah. We're on there. It's linked to our Facebook page. I don't know our individual.
Twitter, all that stuff too, or?
Not yet, but we should.
All right.
Well, we'll work on that. Get current.
Okay, band.
You gotta be more marketable.
Probably the Twitter thing. Any shows coming up?
We're playing the Metal for Life show. That's a flyer right there.
That's put on by Monica. They do it every year.
Monica, that's a great show.
Metal for Life, we're playing there with Monagon.
July 28th, it's on a Saturday, and it's actually a charity event for kids. For the kids.
Yeah,
it's an all-day event, yep. Yeah. So then there's always a lot of good metal bands in there. So I think it starts at about 10 a.m. and it goes pretty much all day, all night.
As long as everybody wants it to go.
10 a.m. to 10 p.m. and I think there's even a few bands after 10 p.m. for like an after party. So come on out.
Yeah, sure. Well, Piranha, this was fantastic. Thanks for letting us invade your space. Thanks, Slayermike.
Thank you, Slayermike.
Thanks, Slayermike.
Sick of the way that you always take it out. Sick of Alberta.
Come on, come on, come on.